观众朋友们好，现在是美国东部时间8月25日，这里是华尔街网报当日第三期节目。现在我们继续为您带来有关中国以及世界的最新消息。如果喜欢，请记得为节目点赞，并请订阅我们的频道。今天首先为您关注到的是俄罗斯反对派领袖纳瓦尔尼今天在狱中受访的有关情况。他在接受《纽约时报》采访时表示，在狱中被迫每天观看8小时的国营电视，有如身处中国劳改营。他说，不断经历洗脑宣传，这是心理暴力。他说，就像在中国的劳改营中，每个人都排队行进，四处还架设着摄影机，面临控告和告密文化。纳瓦尔尼特别表示，每天都要看数个小时的国家宣传影片，接受官方舆论洗脑，而且狱卒还会监视他们，不允许他们阅读写字，而且会把那些睡着的人叫醒，实在痛苦不堪。再为您关注到的是贺锦丽出访亚洲有关情况。根据来自路透社的报道，越南国家主席阮春福今天与美国副总统贺锦丽会面。有趣的是，贺锦丽在与阮春福会见过程中特别强调，有必要找到方法对北京施压，让他遵守联合国海洋法公约，并挑战他恃强凌弱而且过度的海洋主张。但是根据来自路透社的报道，越南官方媒体越通社在晚间发布的有关贺锦丽演讲通稿中，对于抨击北京当局的内容却直接删掉了。通稿只说，贺锦丽说美国支持强大独立繁荣的越南继续创新，扩大与国际接轨，并在东南亚国家协会和地区扮演越来越重要的角色。双方要确保南海航行与飞越安全和自由，南海争端都应在国际法基础上和平解决，包括1982年的联合国海洋法公约，并根据国际法尽快制定南海行为准则等。再为您关注到的是来自彭博社的有关报道。彭博社文章介绍，因为最近德尔塔疫情的冲击，中国经济成长动能显示出明显不足，同时中国的消费工业增加值和固定资产投资增速不及市场预期，社会融资信贷成长回落至阶段低位。而在七月底召开的政治局会议上，投资者看不到有关于下半年民办教育、科技、房地产等行业监管放松的信号。文章引述渣打银行首席经济学家的话说，监管政策中很多是以前一直想做的事，只是在经济复苏时同时推出。但他表示，决策者会评估是否造成经济下行过快，如果突破下限可能会进行调整。同时文章表示，决策层多次强调跨周期调节。八月份的国务院常务会议又提出要加强跨周期调节，保持经济运行在合理空间。而彭博社引述经济学家预测显示，中国2021年 GDP 成长预计达到8.5%，比大多数主要经济体的增速仍然快。只是在监管环境不确定的情况下，未来经济是否出现更多逆风，仍有很大不确定性。再为您关注到的是周江勇家族案件的更多情况，这里一起来看到的是《星岛日报》的报道。文章介绍，杭州市委书记周江勇日前因涉嫌严重违纪违法受查，而有凤凰周刊赴其家乡进行调查，证实其弟弟周建勇和他的乡亲周文勇一起经商建立商业帝国，涉及能源、汽车、地铁，并且与蚂蚁集团有商业合作。而周建勇本人也在山东接受调查，周文勇则经因为涉嫌走私废物罪而被捕，而目前蚂蚁尚未作出回应。根据凤凰周刊旗下的新媒体账号报道，周江勇的家乡位于宁波，而距离宁波区市大概是33公里，是一个小村庄。他的叔父周建芳证实，周江勇的弟弟周建勇是上海理工大学管理学院的副教授。而根据媒体介绍，2008年，周建勇和他的同乡周文勇一起创立了宁波永润工贸，专门生产润滑油，之后成立了多家民营石化企业。周江勇先后主政宁波、舟山，凭着出海优势，使得两个地方作为石化生产贸易加工重要基地，从中牟利。周建勇之后又把眼光投向了互联网、大数据和信息技术行业，方向确定在地铁，并且对准宁波和杭州，正好与他的哥哥周江勇的仕途轨迹相重合。 2017年时，周建勇创立了优城联合信息技术发展公司，聚焦地铁互联网加、行业信息化、地铁新经济三大业务板块。2019年，优城联合被上海云鑫创业入股，成为第二大股东。而上海云鑫的董事长是景贤栋，母公司则是蚂蚁科技集团。在杭州，周建勇的优城联合与投资方阿里巴巴、杭州地铁集团共同成立了杭铁优城科技有限公司，而杭铁优城由优城联合、杭州市地铁集团、蚂蚁集团共同出资1000万成立，蚂蚁出资135万是第三大股东。但是周建勇的商业图谋在7月却出现了逆转，先是相亲周文勇被查，接着8月21日，哥哥杭州市委书记周江勇也被查。而报道引述知情人士表示，此前有人找到周江勇，希望他主动说自己的错误，而周江勇沉默一阵，后来被当局带走。周建勇则随后在山东被有关部门羁押，而与此同时，专项政商关系治理正在杭州展开。而针对周江勇案的有关情况，华尔街电视特别采访到了著名的政治问题观察学者 Victor Shi。 在谈到有关周江勇案时，他表示重点是浙江，周江勇是该省的高级官员，他有管控全省的能力。人们可能担心这一项调查是否会导致逮捕更多省内高级官员，之前的反腐运动也基本是这样的模式。根据目前宣布的措施，高级官员的直系亲属不应该投资他们家人管辖的公司，但是这确实不应该发生，许多股权交易是在境外完成的，那么中国政府又如何可以查清离岸交易呢？过去可以在香港完成，而现在中国执法机构直接在香港，将使此类交易更难隐藏。而同时 Victor Shi 向我们介绍，有趣的是，习近平在浙江当党委书记时，他曾经看过马云的阿里巴巴。作为省委书记，经济增长显然非常重要，即使经济增长对于仕途没有太大贡献，但是管辖范围的企业具有国际知名度总是好的，创造就业机会看起来也是不错的政绩，因此习近平当时显然支持阿里巴巴。但是当习近平成为党的总书记之后，这意味着他成了掌控整个中国的人，作为国家元首，除了经济增长之外，政治公信力也变得非常重要。对于党内议员习近平，对于太子党来说，他们从小就相信中国共产党是中国唯一的主人。习近平可能不喜欢马云的一些处事方式，比如马云非常高调，在一些公开场合批评政府做事的方式，通过巧妙暗示来表达不满，这是很多商人在中国会做的事，但是马云却非常公开的这么做了。所以对于一个从小就相信中国共产党至高无上的人来说，随着时间的推移，马云的行为可能刺痛习近平，而结果正如现在，习近平对于阿里和蚂蚁集团以及中国其他所有科技公司的态度显然发生了很大的转变。当然，人们对于马云的行为是否过分指责呢？部分原因也是因为领导层非常保守，他们相信世界不会变，党应该对中国发生的一切有绝对的发言权，而这种保守的立场也是我们导致看到一些政策变化的原因。
And as the president has made clear, no state or locality should delay in distributing resources. He received a briefing yesterday on the 90-day origins report. It was a classified briefing, so of course that's not information we would provide publicly. Because of the prioritization we've given to this and the importance of this information for the public, the intelligence community has been simultaneously working on an unclassified version of summary, a summary version to provide publicly. I don't have a timeline for you on when that will be provided, but they've been working expeditiously to prepare that, and we have also been doing classified briefings. But until that unclassified version is available, I won't be able to provide any more details of the assessment.
What is President Biden prepared to do to push the Chinese on the Wuhan lab investigation? There's been reporting that the Chinese are not being cooperative. They're pushing back at the U.S. on that. What is he prepared to do to free up more information on that?
Well, I think it's well known they haven't been cooperative, right? Through your reporting, other reporting, and just the fact that they obviously have not in a publicly available way provided the data and the information that we have been requesting. In terms of an assessment of what steps we might take, I don't have anything to preview for you on that front.
But is there any scenario where President Biden would be satisfied with an inconclusive result about the origin of the pandemic that killed so many Americans?
I can assure you the president wants to get to the bottom of the root causes of COVID-19 that has, as you noted, has killed hundreds of thousands of Americans, and wishes that there had been more done earlier on to get to the bottom of it and to, of course, save more lives. Go ahead.
Updates on the timeline?
I don't have any updates on the timeline, no. Okay, thanks everyone.
Dr. Maria Van Kerkhove, technical lead for COVID-19. Dr. Ibrahim Asose-Fall, our assistant director general for emergency response, and Dr. Bruce Aylward, who is the lead for the ACT Accelerator. Today we're having...
Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. After increasing for nearly 2 months, the global number of COVID-19 cases and deaths was stable last week. But it's stable at a very high level, more than 4.5 million cases and 68,000 deaths. However, the situation is very different from region to region.
And in fact, there is no delay in how those studies can be conducted in China because there are many, many capable scientists there that can carry those out without delay. So we are also in agreement about the urgency to continue those studies.
Good afternoon, everybody. Today, more than 10 experts who took part in the mission in Wuhan in January have lamented in the...
In fact, we have heard from Chinese colleagues that studies are underway from some public statements that they have made recently. So again, we want the origins work to be remain scientific, transparent, urgent, and inclusive. And
some of these studies are happening. So actually, Chinese scientists are doing the origin study on their own now, or is the other team going to China?
We've heard statements from our Chinese colleagues that there are studies that are underway in China. We would have to ask them specifically what those studies are, and we look forward to the results of those. As has been outlined in the international report, these include studies of looking at serology, looking at sera that is stored from 2019, looking at tracing back of animals that are there. I don't have the specifics on these exact studies. We very much look forward to what those studies are.
Allow me to ask. Yeah, I mean, I
have... perspective of our Chinese counterparts, it is a contradiction if you're saying that the lab hypothesis is a non-starter from a Chinese perspective, but we need to now go and look at labs in other countries. I find that difficult to understand, but very willing to engage with our Chinese colleagues to understand what exactly they mean by that statement.
Thank you for watching.